I'm Janice McMillan of the Recalibrate Your Life show. I'm excited that you tuned in because I believe that recalibrate is essential to a healthy life. And today I have with me Dr. Godfrey, who is going to be talking today about building bridges. Thank you for being a part of my show.
Thank you for having me.
Dr. Godfrey, can you share with my audience who you are and what you do?
I am Dr. Michael Renee Godfrey. I'm in private practice in Marietta, Georgia. I have a doctorate in sport and performance psychology, as well as specialty training in hypnotherapy, distance counseling, Christian sex therapy, and equine assisted psychotherapy.
All right. Well, we're going to jump right in. As a therapist, what is the number one reason why people find themselves making destructive decisions in their life?
Not valuing themselves and not feeling like they are good enough.
Good enough. What is good enough?
Feeling like you are capable, competent, worthy, valuable. When people feel like I'm not good enough, or I'm too fat, or I'm this, I'm that, why even try? They just kind of give up and they make destructive decisions. I'm going to use drugs, or I'm going to overeat, or I'm going to withdraw and isolate myself so that no one can see that my life is out of control.
Do a lot of people suffer from that today, not feeling good enough?
Absolutely.
Yeah. You know, is that something that's been passed down? You know, parents don't feel that way, so they unconsciously pass that thing down to their children as well.
A lot of times, yes. I think parents probably do the best that they can do. Mm-hmm. But quite often, parents write very negative things on their children's souls. Mm. And we carry that into adulthood. Mm-hmm. I actually wrote a book about it called Soul Graffiti, because to me, it looks like they have written this negative, nasty stuff on your soul wall, and you have to wash it off and replace it mm-hmm. with the positive. Mm-hmm. Just because you didn't get it as a child doesn't mean that you can't get it for yourself as an adult.
Wow. Well, I believe that we live in a society where everybody is so preoccupied with themselves and their own problems. How do we break out of that mindset where we're always looking at me?
That's a good question. We are a society of individualism. Me first. I think when you learn to give mm-hmm. to others and start to realize how good that feels, then you do it more and more. But on the same token, if you feel like you don't have anything to offer and you're drowning in your own depression, you're really not thinking about helping anybody else.
Mm-hmm. Well, how prevalent is depression now with just regular people? I mean, we look at, we have everything. Our parents, maybe our grandparents, they didn't have what we had, mm-hmm. but we have everything. You know, we have jobs, we have material things. Mm-hmm. Why are we depressed?
Because we don't have self-worth. Mm-hmm. Our happiness, our value depends on external things and sources and people. And when that is the case, you're bound to get let down because somebody's not going to give you the compliment you thought you should have, or you're not going to have a Lamborghini like the next person or whatever. When you feel good on the inside, that carries you a lot further. You know, my mother taught me the less it takes to make you happy, the happier you will be.
That's powerful. And I think that's probably why they were so happy back then, because Absolutely. They didn't have much, mm-hmm. you know, so they relied on one another. Mm-hmm. If you just tuned in, this is the Recalibrate Your Life show. with Janice McMillan, and today I am talking to Dr. Michael Renee Godfrey, and we're talking about the importance of building bridges in our life. We're coming on our first break, and we will be right back with the Recalibrate Your Life show.
I just like to give an encouraging word to you sisters to let you know that your happily ever after can still happen. I was 37, single mom, raising two sons by myself, and just happened to be, you know, carousing on Facebook and happened to get a request from this handsome fella next to me. And you know, once you've been hurt, you're always suspect of everybody. Hey, how you doing? What do you want? You know, for one, you're going to have to, like, take down that mega fierce evil, you know. Mm-hmm. You have to take down that attitude. Take that down. Take a chip off the hurt. Chip it off. You know, and if you can't, you pray and ask God to help you. And then the remainder of that wall, he's going to send that which you need to help you to break down that wall. You know, love can help you conquer many things. Again, you get out of your own way. Embrace, walk in your truth, whether you've been, you know, hurt by domestic violence, whether you've been raped, whether you've been molested, whatever your truth is, you own that truth first, ask God to help you, and then you pray and you wait to be found. Don't go seeking. You don't go look for your husband. Your husband finds you. The Bible says when a man finds a wife, you stay in a place of waiting. Don't go out and advertise, you know, you showing your goods, because when you get a man by showing your goods, that's all he gonna want you for. You need a man that's gonna see your spirit and that's going to bless your spirit, pray for your spirit. You need a man that's gonna pray for you and not pray on you.
Welcome back. I'm Janice McMillan, and I am the host of the Recalibrate Your Life show. And every session I talk about recalibrate, and I wanna continually keep that in your ear because it's so very important to understand what Recalibrate is all about. It's about going in another direction. And today I'm talking with Dr. Michael Renee Godfrey, and we're talking about the importance of building bridges in your life. Now, Dr. Godfrey, how important is building bridges to overcome emotional, spiritual, maybe even physical problems?
It's very important because it's always easier to do something or get through life with somebody helping you. Sure, you might be able to do it by yourself, but you could also share the load. Mm-hmm. If you were lifting a big box, you wouldn't try to hurt yourself. Mm-hmm. You would ask somebody for help. Mm-hmm. So in building bridges, you have people walking the journey with you. You have people there that you can lean on when the journey gets hard. Mm-hmm. You have people there to help you when you stumble, because it's not about the fall, it's about how you get back up.
Now, from a therapeutic perspective, you know, we live in a global society now. It's just not Pookie and Sister Girl, you know. Mm-hmm. We have cultures that we've never really engaged with before. How important is it really to get out there now and engage with people that are not like you? Is that a way to help build strong bridges in your life?
I think it's a great way to build bridges because it lets you see a different perspective. Mm-hmm. I lived in Costa Rica for a while, and they're some of the happiest people I've ever met. And they make maybe $50 a month. Mm-hmm. But they don't have the issues that we have. Mm-hmm. In this country. So it changed the way that I looked at my own life to see they choose to be happy with mm-hmm. what they have. Mm-hmm. And they have family events and they have friends over. And that is what's important to them, not making the next dollar or getting the next iPhone. So after coming back, after living there, it made me look at my own life and say, you know, I need to maybe reprioritize some things. Mm-hmm. And I think if we do that as a people, it will open our minds and let us see that it's not just about this small space.
Mm-hmm. Mm-hmm. Now, as a therapist, I know that you have services that a lot of people depend on you for. And since we're talking about building bridges, I'm going to share six key areas that people struggle with. And I want you to share how they can build a bridge out of that struggle. Okay?
Okay.
And we're going to start with depression. How can they build a bridge out of depression?
Open your mouth and let somebody know that you're struggling and that you need help. Whether that's a therapist, your best friend, your pastor, just let somebody know, and you would be surprised how people will step up to be there and walk the journey with you.
Self-esteem.
Be honest with yourself first, and then ask your friends to tell you what they see. And accept the good that they say. Listen to the bad and see if you want to change it or not. But again, you have to have more feedback than just what's in your own head.
Now I want to do a part two to that. What if your friends don't have good self-esteem? Where are you going to go? How are you going to build a bridge out of that?
That's a good question. For that, you would probably have to get a professional help.
Maybe somebody to come see you.
Right. Come see me. A therapist is going to be more objective.
Okay. Grief and loss. I lost my mom in January. And so what is a bridge to help someone who has experienced grief and loss?
That bridge could be your spiritual faith, your church family, your therapist. Mm-hmm. Again, it's inviting people in to support you while you go through that, because mm-hmm. grieving is very difficult. It's exhausting. And sometimes you just want to be able to lean on somebody,
right,
and feel what you feel.
Intimacy. I know that you you deal with couples, mm-hmm. couples therapy. How can they build a bridge out of a place of lack of intimacy?
That bridge needs to start in their relationship. Mm-hmm. They need to build a bridge between each other, because a lot of times that's what's lost. They're each standing on the end trying to talk to each other, and the messages are not getting through. So just making a commitment to do this together mm-hmm. would be the first step, and then getting some outside help, your pastor or a therapist. I tell all couples, the only other person in your marriage should be your pastor or your therapist. Mm, that's it.
Now, what if that couple haven't mended whatever they needed to mend in that intimacy stage, and now they're faced with divorce? How does someone who is divorced from their spouse or mate, how do they build a bridge to overcome those feelings of rejection and, you know, all the things you feel when you divorce?
There are divorce support groups where you can talk to other people who have been through that, so that you're not feeling like you're all alone and mm-hmm. I'm the only person that's ever gone through this. Your girlfriends, mm-hmm. Your guy friends, they come in handy. But people can't help you if they don't know that you need help.
Right.
We try to put on a brave face a lot of times and right. then act like, well, nobody ask me how I'm doing. Well, if you're looking like everything's fine and you're not being honest, they don't know that you need them.
And last, anger management. Briefly, if you can share a bridge to come out of anger.
A bridge for anger would be maybe learning meditation, learning a different way to cope, whether that's through reading a book, watching your show maybe, just again, looking outside of yourself to see how can I do this better, because this is not working, obviously.
Yeah. Well, I am so grateful that you were able to participate on my show, Recalibrate Your Life. And please share with my audience your contact information, and I want you to just give briefly your last words.
My website is www.therapywithdrg.com. My phone number is 678-401-8106. My last word would be a closed mouth doesn't get fed. So if you need help, just say so and give your friends a chance to step up and be there for you.
Well, you know, I'm going to extend this because we're going to come back again and we're going to talk a little bit more after the break. We're going to take another break. This is the Recalibrate Your Life show with Janice McMillan, and we'll be right back. Welcome back. I am Janice McMillan with the Recalibrate Your Life show. And I'm excited because I've never had a therapist on my show. So I know that what she is providing is helping you in whatever area that you may be struggling with. Today I have Dr. Michael Renee Godfrey, and we're talking about the importance of building bridges in your life. Now, I've never been to a therapist, and I'm sure there are people that have never spoken with a professional. Can you provide just some techniques that people can do on their own to overcome whatever that they might be going through, or the techniques that you use during your therapy sessions?
Well, therapy can be intimidating because you're talking to a stranger. You're opening up your life, you're being honest that maybe things are not going as well as they seem. But having said that, it also gives you an opportunity for some objective feedback. Mm-hmm. Part of therapy is, yes, sitting on the couch, talking back and forth, but there are also things like hypnotherapy that can help people deal with some tougher issues. I use equine-assisted psychotherapy with my horse, Hershey, which gives people real-time feedback on their behaviors and what's happening with them. For example, social anxiety, if they're worked up, the horse is far away. When they learn to calm down, the horse comes closer, and they can use that same technique when they're out at a party trying to meet strangers or whatever. Distance counseling is something I use via video conference. If somebody is maybe not comfortable or not able to come into the office, so that's something that we do. I'm what you call an experiential therapist, so I'm kind of in your face, very realistic. I deal with what's happening in the room. I don't coddle and say, oh, you know, that's so bad. I'm about empowering my clients and helping them to realize and or remember that they are powerful. They just have to tap into it sometimes, or we have to clear some clutter so that they can see it, embrace it, and then use it.
Body language tells a lot about people. And I'm going to use myself as an example. You're the therapist. My body language to you, what can I improve on, or what is good that you are seeing from me? What am I emanating? So you're on now as a therapist.
Right now you're very open, and I think that's a good way to approach life. If somebody comes in and they're immediately protected, this is a defense thing. I'm not going to let you get close. Being open, the arms open, you're leaning forward, that tells me that you're interested in what I'm saying. That's going to encourage me to keep talking. And these are things that people can do at work, in meetings. Just having a relaxed body language that says, I'm here, I'm present, I'm paying attention.
That's good. You know, I think so many people are afraid of people. You know, there's a lot going on out here now. And a lot of people don't want to be open to other people. So they are closed.
Sure.
You know, but I think that is a good way to, I guess, disarming people. Body language is a good way to disarm people.
Yes. And facial expressions. You know, black women, we're good for facial expressions.
Oh, we do. I have the line.
So learning to relax your face is important.
Yeah.
Smiling. People think that's so simple, but just smiling changes the tone of your voice.
Yeah.
It changes the way people perceive you. So something just as simple as smiling more often.
Yeah, yeah. Now, as we approach our closing, I'd like for you to share with our audience just some of your other services that you provide. And one of the, I know that there is a lot of sexual dysfunction that's out here.
Mm-hmm.
How do you address that?
Depends on what the dysfunction is. We talk about what's happening, and then there are certain exercises that you can do depending on what the dysfunction is, if it's premature ejaculation or anorgasmia, not being able to have an orgasm. There are different sensate exercises that we can do to heighten or decrease the negative sensation.
Mm. So do men frequent your service?
They do.
Your therapy?
They do.
Mm-hmm.
And that's hard for some men, but the outcome is what they're looking for. So in the end, they realize I took a leap of faith and it was kind of hard, but now I'm able to perform to my best ability.
Well, I really appreciate you being on the Recalibrate Your Life show. If you would share with my audience your website and how they might be able to get in contact with you.
My website is www.therapywithdrg.com. My phone number is 678-401-8106.
Thank you.
Thank you for having me.
Well, we've come on the closing of the Recalibrate Your Life show, and I want you to tune in next week, because each week what we want to do is bring to you messages that will empower you, that will expand your territory, and that will help you to enter into a more healthy place in life. I'm Janice McMillan. I am the host of the Recalibrate Your Life show, and I will see you next time.